Good day. We all know there are three flight modes in Betaflight, right? Angle, Horizon, and Acro. What if I told you there's actually five? That's right, there's five, and I'll briefly do a recap of a few of them. But today, just in time for the Northern Hemisphere's whoop season, I'm going to introduce you to a new Betaflight mode called Level Race Mode, which came out with the Betaflight 4.2 release earlier this year. I'll explain what Betaflight Level Race Mode is, how to set it up in Betaflight in just two simple steps, and describe how it can be used not only for fast whoop flights, but quite possibly for cinematic cinewhoop flights too. Sound useful? Then make sure to hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. Betaflight Level Race Mode is Betaflight's implementation of Not Fast Enough's race mode, also known as NFE race mode, in silverware. I've got links to Not Fast Enough's YouTube channel in the video description below, along with his GitHub site. So let's go to the Betaflight Modes tab to check it out. Let's see, most folks are familiar with, or at least have heard of, Angle Mode, Horizon Mode, and Acro Mode, which is enabled by default when you don't have Angle Mode or Horizon Mode set up on a switch and selected. A mode that's not as commonly known, and one I highly recommend using when first starting out, is Acro Trainer Mode, down here. But I don't see Level Race Mode. That's okay, it's not here. I'll demonstrate in just a little bit how to set up Level Race Mode. It's really simple. But first, let's do a quick recap of the Betaflight modes we do see in this Modes tab, because a few of the things relating to them also apply to Level Race. Both Angle and Horizon modes are what are known as self-leveling modes, which use the accelerometer on your flight controller to automatically level your quadcopter without any stick inputs. The difference between these two modes is that in angle mode, the quadcopter is limited to a maximum angle on both the pitch and roll axis, which you can set to whatever value you'd like in the PID tuning tab, right here. Since it is angle limited, you're not able to do any flips or rolls. Whereas in horizon mode, although the quadcopter uses accelerometer-assisted self-leveling, it's not angle-limited, and you can actually do flips and rolls. There are a couple settings you can change in these self-leveling Betaflight modes, which I'll briefly explain, because as I mentioned, they also apply to the Level Race Betaflight mode, which you'll see here shortly. In both Angle and Horizon Betaflight modes, you can set the auto-leveling level strength here, anywhere from 0 to 200. Where the default is 50. This is how hard the self-leveling feels to you on your transmitter sticks. The higher the number, the harder it's going to feel on your sticks. It's like stretching a spring or rubber band. The more you stretch it, the harder it resists. For our purpose, I'm going to drop this number to 25 for both angle and horizon to make it weaker because I don't like the feel of fighting the quad. Click save. For horizon mode, you also have the ability to set a transition over here between self-leveling and acro behavior with a horizon transition number anywhere from 0 to 200. This setting actually does two things. First, whatever number you set this at is the angle at which your quad will go from self-leveling to acro, no more self-leveling. So for example, if you set this to 25 and roll your quad beyond 25 degrees, it's going to act as if it's in acro mode. Secondly, this transition number also determines the sensitivity of the self-leveling strength to your stick movements. That's a little bit more difficult for me to understand, but let me try to explain. Per the Betaflight GitHub, if you set this horizon transition to 100, all or 100% of your self-leveling strength will be applied at center stick, half of your self-leveling strength, or 50%, is going to be applied at half stick deflection, and at full stick deflection, no self-leveling will be applied. On the other hand, if you set this value to 50, all or 100% of your self-leveling strength will be applied at center stick. None will be applied, or you'll be in acro mode from half stick deflection and beyond, and in between at a quarter stick deflection from center stick, you're going to have half of your leveling strength applied. So the higher this transition number, the weaker the self-leveling will be near center stick. Let's go ahead and change this to 100. Click save. With our horizon strength set to 25, and our transition set to 100, we should get just a little bit of an assist from our accelerometer self-leveling. Now, as I mentioned, if we don't have angle or horizon mode enabled, your default mode is acro mode, which is not a self-leveling mode, nor is it angle limited. In Acro mode, you have the complete control of the quadcopter, and it's going to keep its last position based on your stick inputs. Acro trainer mode, which once again I highly recommend using when starting out, is exactly the same as Acro mode. However, it is angle limited based on an angle you set in the PID tuning tab over here. I do highly recommend using this mode when first starting out, and as a matter of fact, for more on Acro trainer mode, check out this video on FPV beginner tips. Alright, so what's level race Betaflight mode? Well, it's basically a hybrid Betaflight mode of either angle or horizon with Acro mode, where your accelerometer is used for self-leveling on the roll axis only. You're in full Acro mode on the pitch axis, and therefore your quad's going to maintain its pitch position and speed based on your last stick input until that pitch position is changed by a stick movement in the opposite direction. It can be used with either angle mode, which will limit your roll angle. This would be the angle acro hybrid, or in horizon mode, which will not limit your roll angle, so you can do rolls, and this would be the horizon acro hybrid. You must have either angle or horizon enabled to use the level race Betaflight mode, since it is a self-leveling mode as described by its name. So as a recap, here's a chart that describes all five of the Betaflight modes we have available to us, and whether or not they're self-leveling and angle limited. For this video, I'll complete our first step by setting up horizon mode in Betaflight and my modes on switch C in my transmitter mixes page on channel 6, which is aux 2, as you see here. For our second step, we go to our CLI, which is nothing to be afraid of. Make sure to check out this video on useful CLI commands. In our CLI, we type in the command set space level underline race underline mode equals on and press return on our keyboard. Then we type save, hit return on our keyboard. And to check that our command saved correctly, we go back into the CLI and type get level, hit return, and here we see that it did save it correctly. That's it, we've set up level race Betaflight mode on our quad for whenever we're in angle or horizon mode. Remember our little accelerometer self-leveling assist we set up in horizon mode with our strength set to 25 and our transition set to 100? Now in level race mode, that's only going to occur on the roll axis. So we ought to be able to pitch forward as little or as much as possible while flying a whoop around while maintaining control, but at the same time, if we use this for cinematic flights on any quad, including a cinewhoop, our movements on the roll axis should be very smooth. The level race is another of the many Betaflight modes you can use for fast whoop flights, to learn FPV flight,
and for cinematic FPV flights too. You can set up Betaflight Level Race Mode in just 2 steps and access it on a switch whenever you want. Let me know in the comments below if you plan on using Betaflight Level Race Mode with your whoop flights or as an assist with your cinematic cinewhoop flights. When you do try it out, let me know how it works for you. Looking forward to hearing from you soon, and until then, thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.